In this video, I'm going to take you shopping in my favorite tile store and show you all the tips and tricks for shopping for tile. Wow. So if you're like most people, you've got a preconceived idea that your selection for tile is pretty much limited to what you find at the local box stores. Let's face it, kids, one look in a place like this and you know you've been ripped off all these years. And once you get over the initial shock of the situation, here's my five tips for going shopping for tile. Tip number one, go for a tour of the whole store before you ask anybody for any help. It's a good idea to see what the latest trends are, what are the different options that you have for tile, size, color, texture. Get all that in your brain, absorb it all in, take a minute to really go, wow, it's gonna blow your mind, the options that are available, and then maybe it's time to go and talk to this professional. Step number two, go find the designer. A place like this has got a lot of staff on hand who are trained designers, who know their products, who spend a lot of time finding out what products are in the store, so they can help you with your search. They can help you refine your search, they can help you expand your ideas, maybe change some understandings and some mental blocks you have. Like for instance, is that gonna look good on a floor? I don't know, ask the designer. Step number three is make sure you understand the difference between ceramic, porcelain, and natural stone. They all install just a little bit different and require different tools for cutting. So if you're a DIYer, you may want to pick the ceramics, maybe push into some of the softer porcelains, but moving into hard porcelain, natural stone can be a real challenge unless you're willing to put out a lot of money for cutting tools. Step number four, know your limitations. Just because products like this are available doesn't mean it's a good idea for you. Trust me, the guys that install this have been specially trained and have all the tools and equipment necessary to install it. Don't think you're just gonna cut it in half and put it in your shower. Step number five is know your budget. Now listen, just because it's big doesn't mean it's gonna be simple. The truth is, when the bigger the stone that you buy, the more waste you're gonna have on your project, all right? So you can't even order this by the square foot. You might have a 100 square foot shower, but you can't just order 100 square feet of this. You're probably gonna need 120 or 130 square feet for every 100 square feet you wanna install. So a lot of waste. So that takes the price times maybe 0.4, 0.5. You're gonna spend 1.5 times as much on big stone as you will something small, because you're not gonna throw any of that in the garbage. And the best deals in the store are here, found in the discount area. Almost every store is gonna have a room dedicated to all their end of inventory stock. This is the place where you get the most sensational deals, usually half off. What a deal. You can get some of the biggest, best, most amazing stuff that they've ever sold in this room, and it's just, they're out of stock now and they're not gonna be replacing it. Now remember, if it's out of stock now, it means that somebody else paid full price last week for it, and you're just gonna have what's left over. In a lot of cases, you can get enough for your kitchen or your backsplash or your shower, not a problem. This is the best place on earth as far as I'm concerned. I'm like a kid in a candy store in the discount area. So there we go. That's my five major tips for going shopping at a tile store. Now remember, when you're there, you're gonna have your designer. So don't forget to put them to work for you. Let them show you about all the cements and the grouts that are gonna be best for your situation. They're all trained in the products. They also know how to pick out the right metal trims or plastic trims, the different depths. Every stone here is just a little thicker or thinner, so they've got trims to finish off your edges. Every kind of product that they have in the store, that's absolutely amazing help. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask them. Do not ever make a purchase without having the whole process complete from A to Z, because you don't want to go buy tile from one place and then products from another, because if you have any problems after that, the problem is going to be yours. So if you do all your purchasing in one location, then you can go back to them and say, hey, this product didn't work out because you told me so. And they're not afraid of taking on that responsibility. So make sure you check with them about all of your selections. If you like this kind of information and you'd like us to go through more things like this for you, then just give us a thumbs up and ask all your questions about tile and stone in the comment section below. Okay, I've been working with these guys for 18 years. I think I got a good handle on what's going on in this store, and I should be able to answer all your questions. We'll see you again next time. And if you want to learn how to be a tile expert, then click the link right here.